Hey, what's up, guys? So you guys can see, I'm going to do a small review on my brand new Colt King Cobra 357 Magnum. This is going to be a smaller unboxing. I won't talk too much about the gun because I don't have much experience with it. I shot it a couple times, love the gun. All I know, it's a 357. It also takes 38 special. Besides that, the gun itself, it's a gorgeous piece of art. It's a beautiful gun. So here we have it. We have a plastic carry box, I guess you can say. It's not the best quality, to be honest with you. It's kind of flimsy. It's not all that thick, but it's way better than a cardboard box, so I'm not complaining. But let's get to it. Let's put this down, open it up. Here we have it. Nice foam to keep the gun steady and safe. We have one of the locks that actually goes into the barrel and would go through the cylinder and just lock up like most regular locks. We also have the owner's manual, Colt King Cobra revolver. Nothing special, I guess. If you want to look into the gun or know the parts or know the parts itself, it's all there. I mean, you guys can see it's a small diagram of each part of the gun. Tools required for cleaning, I guess. It also teaches you how to clean it. I mean, it's all there. It's I guess what comes with a gun, or what should come with a gun when you purchase a gun, handgun at least. I actually purchased this gun in the state of New Jersey hoping I would carry this, but it's after shooting it a couple of times and just carrying it, and being that the barrel is so short, it's kind of hard to aim, hard to hit anything over 25 yards or 25 yards, at least for me. I'm new to the gun scene, and I don't have much experience with shooting, but this guy's tough to aim. But yeah, let's start unboxing this thing, or unwrapping it because it comes in plastic. But yeah, this gun's a beauty. You guys can see, you have a little horse there for the Colt, and then we have, this is actually some type of engraved King Cobra 357 Magnum. As you guys can see, it's a polished finish, so that's gonna be fun trying to keep this clean. As you guys can see right here, we have some burn marks from some of the shots we've shot before. But yeah, let's get this guy off so I don't rip it off. We have the cylinder release. Super nice, super cool gun. This is what is dual action. Actually, so if you're shooting like this, this is considered dual action. And if you shoot it like this, then you bring it down to single action. As you guys can see, it literally makes a huge difference. You shoot it like this, the trigger itself goes all the way back to the proper position of shooting or making a dual action. And so look, we have it there. And then if you bring back the hammer manually, then your trigger turns into single action. So there's barely any pressure at that point, which is much better. I enjoy it this way, but I also don't like any guns that are dual action. It just makes it a little harder to press on the trigger. And in most cases, when you're new to the gun, you could be aiming, and because you're anticipating the shot, you bring it up higher than you're supposed to, especially when it's dual action, because since it's taking so long for you to pull on the thing, you're bringing it up high. By the time you shoot, you have already aimed maybe 6 inches higher than your initial target. But I don't like any dual actions. After this, most of my guns will be single action. Not a fan of it at all. I do like the gun itself. Maybe that's why I went for it. The gun is gorgeous. And I mean, it's a classic revolver. I was also told by the salesman, he's like, please take care of this gun. These guns are basically an investment. As time goes by, they just increase in value. And if you ever held one, you can tell the type of quality. Yeah, you can definitely tell the quality of these guns. These guns are gorgeous. It's truly a beautiful gun. The grip itself, it's kind of small. If you're a bigger guy with bigger hands, this grip might not suit you at all. It does have a recoil, but it's not as bad as one would think. But it's still a beautiful gun. I mean, especially if you're collecting guns or you're really into guns, you should definitely have a nice classic revolver. This is a 3 3¾ inch barrel, I believe. I rented a 3-inch Ruger revolver, and that thing was a piece of crap. The grip itself was super small. I would say it's maybe it would be up to here. So your hand would be hanging, and it was just shitty, man. It was a really shitty gun, crappy gun. But this one, being that's three quarters longer, it has improved significantly just by the grip itself. But then again, this is a way better gun than a Ruger. These guys been in business forever. Classic Colt. I believe back in the day they were fabricated and assembled in Paterson, New Jersey. So there is a nice history behind these. And yeah, besides that, the gun is gorgeous, and you probably want to clean it every time you shoot it or touch it, because since it's a polished finish, you don't want it rusting or starting to get little specks of water or condensation building up on it. That's definitely something you do not want on a gun. And I mean, as you guys can see, bring it back to a decent finish. Like I said, it's a gorgeous gun. It's real beautiful. If you're thinking about it or you like guns, make sure you add this to your collection. It's super nice. As you can see, we have the rear sight, then we have the front sight. I believe it's a brass. Yeah, I believe it's brass. The front one, at least. The back one isn't. It's just polished. Super cool gun. Super nice. It's beautiful. I do like it. I enjoy it. Nice gun. Let's get the box out the way so we can get better contrast. Look at that. It's a gorgeous gun. It's really beautiful. It's nice gun. But yeah, guys, this is the smaller unboxing of the King Cobra 357 Magnum. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll definitely post a video of me shooting it. If you guys want to see any videos of me shooting or shooting anything, just comment below. I'll gladly do it. But yeah, super cool gun. Not much to talk about. Just a nice little gun.